Hello and welcome to this Google Sheets tips video. I'm Sumit Bansal, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to quickly highlight duplicates in Google Sheets. Last week, I released a video where I showed you how to remove duplicates using an inbuilt functionality in Google Sheets. Unfortunately, there is no inbuilt functionality to highlight duplicates. So we will have to use formulas and conditional formatting to get this done. So here I have these names and you can see there are some repetitions in this data set. I want to highlight all these duplicate names. So in this case, I would first show you what the formula is going to be, and then we will be using that formula within conditional formatting. So the formula is going to be count if, and this would be the entire range that I'm checking. I press F4 to lock this range so that when I go down the cell, this range still refers to this data set here, the names here. And my criteria here would be this name. So what this does is it goes through this data set and counts how many times this name repeats. And now when I hit enter, it gives me 2 here and I can drag this down. And you can see I get these numbers, which represents how many times this name repeats in the data set. Now, I don't want these numbers because in conditional formatting, I can only use a formula that returns either a true or a false. If it is a true, the conditional formatting rule is applied. If it is a false, it's not applied. So in this case, I need to change my formula a little bit and add this condition where this is greater than 1. So if the name repeats only once, then it's a unique name. And if it repeats more than once, then it's a duplicate. So I'm checking whether this number given by COUNTIF is more than 1 or not. And it is going to give me a series of trues and falses. And you can see for every name there, which is duplicate, I would get a true. And for all the unique names, I would get a false. So I'm going to use this formula. Copy this formula here, select this range. You don't need this here. I'm just showing you here because I want to make sure that you understand the formula. Now you select this range of data, go to format, click on conditional formatting, and here make sure that the range is correct and click on custom formula is. So you have this formula format cells if drop down where I've selected custom formula is, and I paste the formula here. And you can select the formatting. In this case, I'll go with the default green. And when I click on done, you can see that here it has highlighted those names where there are duplicates. We do not need this one here, so we can delete this data. Now, what if I don't want to highlight all the duplicate entries? What if I don't want to highlight the first instance of the duplicate name, but only the second instance? So in this case, I don't want to highlight this name and this name here because that's the first instance. I only want to highlight the duplicate instances. So that you can do as well. Let me delete this conditional formatting here and let's recreate the formula. Now in this case, I'm again going to use COUNTIF, but the range would be a little bit different. So in this case, I would use A2 is to A2, where I'm going to lock the first one. What this means is, and not lock the second one, which means there would be no dollar signs for the second reference. What this means is that for this formula in this cell, it is only going to consider this cell here and check whether this name repeats here or not, which would be 1 because it obviously repeats here. But when we go down the cell, it is now going to refer to A2 colon A3, which means only these two names. Then when it goes down further, it is going to repeat, check and count in the 3 cells. So as we are going down, that range increases, which means that for the first instance, this would always be 1. But when more instances of the same name comes up, then the counter formulas would start giving me 2 or 3 or 4, depending on how many times the name repeats. So now this becomes my range, and my criteria in this case would be this name here. And now when I hit enter, it gives me 1. But see what happens when I drag this down? It now gives me 1 in all the cases where the names appear for the first time. But when the name appears for the second time or the third time in a data set, then these numbers would increase and give me 2 or 3 or 4 or whatever the number of times the name appears. So I'm going to use this formula instead. And again, obviously, because it has to be trues and falses, I would make this greater than 1. So now when I drag this down, it becomes trues and falses. Let me copy this formula, select this range of data, go to format, click on conditional formatting. And here in format cells if drop down, click on custom formula is and paste the formula and see what happens. In this case, only these two names are highlighted because these two are the duplicate instances of the names. So if you want to quickly highlight duplicates in a single column, then this is the counter formula that you can use. But what if you have data in multiple columns and you want to go through all the columns and then see whether they are duplicates or not? So let's see how to do that. Here, I have these names, and you can see the names repeat in the entire data set across three columns. So for example, if I come here and I look at Heather, then the name Heather does not repeat in this column, but it does repeat somewhere here. So there are duplicates. Now, again, the concept remains the same. What I'm going to do is use the COUNTIF formula. And this entire thing becomes my range. I would press F4 to lock this, and my criteria in this case would be this cell here. And that's it. That's the formula that is going to give me the result. I can drag this down and I can drag this to the right so that you can see the numbers. And it, because we have locked the overall range for every name, it checks in the entire range and gives me this COUNTIF formula, COUNTIF value. Now, because again, I want trues and falses, I would make this greater than 1. Drag this down, drag this to the right, and you can see this is what I would get. Now again, this is only because I'm going to show you how this formula works. This is why I'm creating this formula right here next to the data set. If you are quite comfortable using formula directly within conditional formatting, you can do that as well. So now I would select this data, go to format, click on conditional formatting. Here again, make sure that the range is correct. If it is not, you can adjust it. Come to format cells if, click on this and select custom formulas, and then enter the formula. And now when you click on done, you'll see that all these names that repeat anywhere in any of these columns would be highlighted. So this is how you can also highlight duplicates in multiple columns. But now what if you want to highlight duplicate records? So here, let's see an example. Here I have the names, the department, and the employee ID, and I have this entire record for an employee. And I want to see whether there are duplicate records. So in this case, if you look closely, we have Henry for marketing with this employee ID, and it also repeats here. Similarly, if you look at Karen, then the record also repeats here. So what I'm trying to look for is whether the entire record is a duplicate or not. And I want to highlight that record. So again, we are going to use a COUNTIF formula, but this time the formula is going to be a little bit complex. So let's see. The first thing I would do is actually combine these, because what I'm going to do is combine all these text in all these cells and check whether that combination is unique or not. So in this case, I would have A2:A10. Then I would press F4 to lock this. Then I would have B2:B10. Then again, press F4 and then ampersand. And then C2:C10. Now, I press F4 to lock this. Now, when I hit enter, it gives me this value here, which is a combination of all these three cells. But I don't want just for this cell. I want it for all these cells. So I would come back here and I would wrap this within array formula, which means that instead of giving me one single value, it is then now give me an array of values. So now when I hit enter, you can see it gives me these values for all these cells. Now, again, what I want to do is I've become a scenario where it's all the data is in one single column, and I just need to figure out whether there are duplicates in the single column or not. So again, I would come back here, use the COUNTIF formula. This becomes my range, and my criteria would be the combination of these three. So I would come here, I would select A2, then again, ampersand B2, ampersand C2. Now, one very important thing that you have to do in this case is you will have to lock the column for each of these cells, which means that I would have to come here and I would make $A2, $B2, and $C2, which means that when conditional formatting is going through all of these cells, when it is in A2, it is going to consider this entire thing as the criteria. But when it goes to B2, it would still consider A2 ampersand B2 ampersand C2 as the criteria. So I don't want this criteria to change. If I don't lock this, then when it moves from A2 to B2, this would change from A2 to A2 would become B2, B2 would become C2, and C2 would become D2. I don't want that change to happen. I want this to remain constant. So this is why I have locked this. And now when I hit enter, it gives me 2. When I drag this down, it gives me all these numbers. If it's a unique record, it will be 1. If there is duplicate, it would be 2. So for example, Henry, there is 2 here because it repeats. Karen, again, 2 here because it repeats. And since I'm working with conditional formatting, I need to convert these into trues and falses. I would make this greater than 1. This becomes my formula. I would copy this formula. Again, you do not really need this entire thing. You can just delete it and work directly within conditional formatting. I just find it easy to create these formulas first in the worksheet and then copy paste it in conditional formatting. So I would select this entire data, go to format, click on conditional formatting, and here make sure that the range is correct. Click on custom formulas and paste the formula here. And now when I click on done, you can see all the duplicate records are highlighted. So these are a couple of scenarios where you can use a combination of formula and conditional formatting to quickly highlight duplicate data in Google Sheets. That's it in this video. I hope you found this useful. Also, if you're liking these videos, please subscribe to this YouTube channel and click on the bell icon so that you never miss out on any new Google Sheets tips video I come up with. Thank you and have a nice day.